unsettled souls. Welcome to the correct use. See, I'm doing political commentary for the media speaks. I also want to mention, I write for the Conservative Daily Post. So go to theconservativedailypost.com. You can see my work. I also do work with Blasting News. I just wrote an article on the mysterious booms that have been heard all over the world on New Year's. Also, show announcement. No more do we have the dunce cap of the year. Nobody voted on what the dunce cap of the year could have been. So we are cutting that out. We're keeping the dunce cap of the month. But mailing these are very expensive, and I think some people get confused every year the difference between the month and the year, so we're not going to do the dunce cap of the year anymore. We are going to give a shout out to The Day the Lights Went Out by D. Alan Ross. I've been carrying him as an advertiser for a moment and love his book. Absolutely hilarious. Do yourself a favor, if you haven't read it, do so. Day the Lights Went Out, D. Alan Ross. Friends, check this out. Trey Sanchez, getting into the dundies in our dunce cap of the month. The stupidest people in our society, all at one time. Texas hate hoax. Man writes N-word lovers on his own home. David confessed to spray painting our garage door. This is from Truth Revolt. Friends, you can see there on screen share what the man did. Now, the reason this matters so much is that everybody remembers how despicable, of course, Charles Manson has been in the news lately, since he's been sick. And people remember that he was hoping to start some kind of a race war in the United States, or to oversee some coming race war that he was doing nothing to try to prevent. And everyone called him insane. He is. Well, now we've got the other side trying to start a race war. The left, I don't mean black and white, the left trying to start a race war. And I mean, this is like back page news, but if people were thinking, and if this was reversed, it would be front page news. You know what I'm saying? They want us at each other's throat all the time, and that's why this is in the Dunce Cap of the Month award show. Listen to this. Another week, another hate crime hoax, this time in Texas, where a man spray-painted N-word lovers on his own garage door and lit his truck and motorcycle on fire. The incident allegedly occurred on the morning of December the 22nd, when David Williams, it says, and his wife Jenny awoke to find their motorcycle and truck was ablaze on their front lawn alongside a racist message on their garage door. After reporting it to the police, Williams later admitted to his wife of perpetrating the vandalism himself. He confessed to spray painting our garage door and starting the fire at our home, Jenny wrote on her Facebook page. A GoFundMe page has been set up to help the family after the incident, but that has since been closed down. Since insurance won't pay for the damage, her husband's antics cost their children's presents on Christmas. In their new GoFundMe page, Jimmy Williams asked the people to help pay for their Christmas gifts. And it makes you wonder, because you know, otherwise the kids are absolutely hosed, but that's not the point. He did this and then says, please pay for my kids' Christmas. The kids won't be able to have anything under the Christmas tree due to this horrible act, wrote Jimmy Williams. Please, if you find it in your heart, donate what you can to help my family of six out. David Williams has since come under psychiatric care for mental hospital. Once released, police state he may face criminal charges. At least it's the wife asking for the money and not the not the husband. But just the same, friends, they are so clearly excited about us fighting each other and being at each other's throat that you've now got things happening like this. People really don't care if a person of another race dates another. If they do care, normally they don't make it known to everybody else, because people are pretty much open to allowing people to do what it is that they want to do. This humongous race problem that so many people are seeing in the country isn't there. But if you make people believe it's there and you keep perpetuating it, then it could be. Thank you. This is a New Mexico School Drops Michelle O. Lunch Rolls as program Future is in Doubt. Now, the reason this made the Dunce Camp of the Month award was because she made the single worst lunch program in the history of the world. We've covered how this wasn't completely her fault, but they buy low-grade food a lot of times, which gets bugs in it. We've shown pictures of the bugs. There is there's a lot of dissatisfaction with children hating their lunch. And you can say, well, Mrs. Obama needs to look over us because our kids are fat. Well, why is it that her kids get leg of lamb with, like, steamed broccoli, and your kid gets a piece of lettuce and a piece of bologna? That is what she has been doing. I mean, literally, the woman is so dense, she can't oversee a lunch school program. And now, it's expensive. That's right, it's expensive now. To give somebody a piece of bologna and a piece of green leaf lettuce now is actually an expense. It's more expensive to give them than it was to give them the poison food they had before. And again, I've always been in favor of organic food. But organic food also hoses people, too. Because they charge way, way more. And they say, well, it costs more because we don't use antibiotics. What, do you think people are giving the antibiotics to the big agriculture for free? They're paying for them. You're not paying for antibiotics. You know what I'm saying? But when it hits the store, the organic food is 100 times more. It costs $28 for three meals. So, I mean, she wasn't giving them organic food. She was giving them a healthier food. And it was more expensive, and it wasn't filling, and it barely meet the nutritional needs of the day. Thank you, Mrs. O. That's why you are on the Dunce Camp of the Month Award Show. Santa Fe, a small New Mexico charter school, is dropping out of the National School Lunch Program because officials contend government subsidies that come with participation aren't enough to cover the expenses. Montel de Sol head learner Robert Jensen told Santa Fe, New Mexican, the Santa Fe, New Mexican, it's a paper, that the school recently notified parents that it can no longer afford to cover the roughly $40,000 a year cost to provide free and reduced price lunches to needy students through the national school program. We receive $3 from the federal government for each free lunch we serve, he wrote to parents last month. However, it costs much more to serve that lunch. For the last several years, the school has been able to pay the difference, but this year, we cannot. Montel de Sola Jones, hundreds of other schools across the nation that have dropped out of the national lunch program since the U.S. Department of Agriculture imposed the state regulations on calories, sugar, fat, sodium, whole grains, fruits, and vegetables. What she's done here is moved in and said, you can't serve Pepsi, you have to serve vitamin water. No, look what I'm drinking. I love vitamin water. I think if you drink Pepsi too much, you're killing yourself. Here's a Mountain Dew that's been sitting here since my party on New Year's Eve. And still, if you overdo it, you die. Okay, and look at me. I'm not a little chubby. I like sweet stuff. But if you don't watch it, if you let it get out of control, you can be very, very small, and it'll still pose a significant problem, which my wife is going to find out someday. She's a tiny, adorable little thing, but she eats nothing but candy and drinks pop like it's going out of style, and, you know, that's how you end up putting needles in you. I mean, there's other things that cause sugar, but that's a big one. We need to understand that doesn't mean that you replace the Pepsi with the vitamin water and then expect the school to pay for the vitamin water. Here's the way that works. If a Pepsi is a dollar, and a vitamin water is $1.50, if every time the school gives a kid a vitamin water, they get 75 cents, Do you see how quickly the more vitamin water the child drinks, the more in the hole your school goes? And then you can raise how much it costs to go there so that nobody can afford it. And then all the kids will end up in public schools, which is what they want to begin with. See how I broke that down for you here on the correct views? Guys, moving on to prisonplanet.com. This is of interest. It's from Zero Hedge. We're just going to cover on it for a minute. A Merry Christmas. Mass brawls break out across America malls. Now, the reason I'm staying on this is because the dunce cap of the month, as you know, goes to the previous month. I can't give you December's dunce cap of the month at December 1st because I don't know who the dumbest person in December was yet. See how that works? This didn't win the Dunce Cap of the Month award largely because I don't know who any of these idiots are. During this season of joy and celebration, it appears not everyone is full of Christmas spirit. Last minute holiday shoppers have been filmed brawling with each other in New Jersey, Alabama, Georgia shopping malls ahead of the holidays. Also during the holidays, a lot of it looks like it was more inner city garbage. I'm gonna go to, you can see it here on FactCam. More people trying to prove how hard they are, like they're trying out for the next rap video or something. And, you know, there you go. That's now Christmas in America. And I think that speaks volumes about not only where we are as a country, but where we look at the things that we used to say really mattered. Now, again, if a fight breaks out in a mall, I get it. You know, I get it. Things happen. But when you see this routinely happening, like again and again and again and again, it's showing that every time we get together in groups, the thugs come out, the bandits come out, the idiots come out. Nobody, it used to be, remember that you see like shows like Scrooge where everybody was like, top of the morning to you. Everybody was really, I guess that was Irish, everybody's really, really happy. And you know, it's the day that you do your best to get along with people who normally you would not get along with. We're seeing the opposite now. We don't even have holidays and Christmas to look forward to anymore. And I don't know, I just think that kind of thing needs to be mentioned. I'm not going to dwell on it forever, but there wouldn't be a Dunce Cap of the Month award show, and I wouldn't have any credibility if I didn't bring you true idiots like this. Slovakian pilot arrested after passing out drunk in the cockpit. Now, when you hear who won the Dunce Cap of the Month award, you're going to say that this guy was stupider. This guy was dumber. He should have got it. Sam, what are you thinking? The problem is, I can't afford to send this dunce cap to Slovenia. Now, if you would like to donate, which I would appreciate, at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com through PayPal, all money given goes towards a better show. I could probably afford to do it. Because this here really does deserve the Dunce Cap of the Month award. Listen to this. A festive period is often a time to be merry, but one pilot took things a little too far by being found passed out in the cockpit of an aircraft before it was headed to Cancun, Mexico from Calgary, Canada. Police arrested Miroslav Golovich, 37, from Slovakia just before 7 a.m. on New Year's Eve after staff noticed the pilot for Canada's Samsung Airlines was behaving strangely before passing out in the cockpit. Prior to the departure, gate crew, it says, and crew aboard the flight noticed that the pilot was behaving oddly before he became unconscious in the cockpit. He should have been drinking vitamin water. And no, they don't pay me, by the way, so feel free not to. A press release from police officials stated the pilot was escorted from the aircraft, at which point he was taken into custody by Calgary police. Now, some of the blame here, you could argue, just a little bit of the blame, would go to a system that maybe would not have allowed him to call off if maybe he overdid it a certain night. Does that mean he doesn't get 95% of the dunce cap for being the one who did it? Of course he does. But I mean, unfortunately, we all do dumb things, so he probably should have just called off, and there probably should have been a system in place for him to be able to do so. Again, you can't have every pilot you have calling off on a holiday, but if someone is a bit inebriated, then maybe they should. And again, you get sometimes you'll go to a bar and they'll pour you a little bit more in a shot than you thought that they were going to. So things like that probably happen quite frequently. But what this idiot did was got passed out drunk and then went to work to fly the airplane. What's funny is, this probably happens quite frequently. Not maybe to this level of drunkenness, but it probably happens quite frequently. And, wow. I'm glad the airplane, in many instances, do a lot of the flying themselves anymore. Otherwise, you'd think you were going to Cancun and end up in Zimbabwe. He was three times over the legal limit 2 hours after his arrest. Hoo-hoo-hoo! At a press conference, police spokesman Paul Stacey said the pilot's actions could have resulted in a potential for a disaster. You think so? The thing is, though, you got to remember, in reality, he's probably only twice what anybody else would consider drunk, because the legal limit is so low that I actually would be fine getting in somebody with... If you had two shots in an hour and a half, the law would call you drunk. I actually would get in an airplane with you. I don't think most people are going to be that inebriated, despite what the law says. If that makes me an irresponsible swine, then so be it. But it's just true. And most of you watching this know it's true, especially if you're a bigger person. That's not always true. I thought it needed mention. But, I mean, literally. There were 99 passengers on board. It was a 737-800 series aircraft with six flight crew, including the pilot. The likelihood of a major airline like this actually being able to take off when they're impaired is pretty slim, because there's a lot of checks and balances. So I'm not surprised that he got caught before the plane left the terminal. Well, that is good to know, anyway, that for sure. And friends, that brings us to the winner, what you have been waiting for, the Dumdy of the day. There's the music. Cheers. Dumdy, 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 the Dumdy of the day. We're going to turn this music off and let you listen to who won the Dunce Cap of the Month award, which would be, drum roll, Green Day. No Trump, no KKK, no fascist USA from Green Day. Okay, Green Day. Let me introduce you to some facts. Fact number one. Fascism is a form of government that is oftentimes racist, we'll get to that in a minute, and always the government controlling what jobs people can have, where they can work in every movement of their life. In terms of spying on people, that would be Obama, and you could argue Bush. That is not likely to be Trump to such a large degree. And Trump is not a fascist. He is for private businesses being allowed to do whatever it is they want. Nazi Germany handed you a shovel and told you to dig. Second of all, what they mean by that is that he is a racist fascist. Well, we've already proved that he wasn't a fascist. Racism. President Obama locks up pot offenders. Your band name of your band is Green Day. Many people know you've talked about getting high in your songs, and you know what? I don't have a problem with it. Look at me. I like punk rock. Okay, Jello Biafra is also left-minded. I had a talk with him at the Danzig show. I was lucky enough to get to meet him. A ministry show, excuse me. I was lucky enough to get to meet him. We don't agree, but I've always respected the man's music. I like his voice, and I think he's right about a lot of things that are wrong in the world. I just don't believe that he has the right solution. I'm not against. I like punk rock. My favorite is probably industrial or thrash, but I love punk rock. I love the whole scene. Anybody that knows me knows that my whole life has been music. I am in a band that has elements of punk in it that is very electronic driven, very jazz driven, and is signed to Night Stalker Records in Akron. Okay, I am part of the quote unquote music community. I get it. The scene, I would say if I was a hipster. I get it. However, they're wrong. Okay? No KKK. Trump doesn't endorse the KKK. He's always said that in about 700 different interviews. Maybe you were busy making false accusations at the time that you did this. I don't know. There's nothing about Trump that is like that. He's trying to help the inner cities. He has been talking about trying to help the inner cities for just about as long as he's been talking. He has done a lot for minorities with the charities that he has been involved with, a lot more than the corrupt charity that is supposed to be the Clinton Foundation. We can also talk about the fact that, and again, Trump didn't publicize what I'm about to tell you. It was actually something that other people had found out later through the woman. Trump allowed a homeless black woman to stay in Trump Tower absolutely free just because she needed a place to go. He didn't advertise it. When he was being attacked on TV, he didn't bring it up. He didn't use her to prove that he wasn't racist. But you know what? People like you, Green Day, are making things much worse for everyone. And that is why you win the Dunce Cap of the Month Award. Dunce! I wrote, "The left locks up people for your name's implication." You support that? There's a big old pot leaf. And again, I'm for the legalization of drugs, not the endorsement of, but I don't have a problem with people deciding what they put into their own body. I have a problem with Green Day supporting people that lock up pot smokers while having a name about pot smoke while attacking a man for being racist who isn't racist. My husband and I lock up black people. Trump's racist. There's a little picture of Hillary Clinton. And last but not least, we've got a bomb. The left under Obama and Hillary bombed more than Bush. Okay, so there is the hat. There is the Dunce Cap of the Month Award right here that is going to be sent to them. That's great. There's a typing error on it. The Dunce Cap of the Month Award, which I now must fix. The Dunce Cap of the Month of December of 2016 goes to Green Day for suggesting that Donald Trump is a KKK supporter or a fascist. It was the left who was overseeing the largest number of nonviolent blacks locked up for a backstage joint of which you name your band after. And yet you claim that Trump is anti-black? You are a bunch of three-chord American idiots. And that's what I wrote right there. For all of you that love punk music, I'm not saying that you need more than three chords. I'm just saying that you don't need to stand up there asking like you reinvented the wheel and criticize people for something that they didn't do. Now, if you don't like Trump because you are, say, a raging pro-lifer, I get it. If you don't like Trump because you really like large taxes, which is the case of Jello Biafra, I don't agree with you, but I can respect that. Trump is anti-tax, you are not anti-tax, I get it. But if you're going to stand there and call someone a racist with absolutely no facts at all, then you might find that you win the Dunce Cap of the Month Award. Good night, friends. God bless. Please donate at the correct views at hotmail.com through PayPal. Thank you.